Bob Kirchhoff, who is the coach of the fine Indianapolis Ron Colley basketball team, and what a job he has done over the seasons. This is his fifth year. He's about 89 and 22, close to that. He's done an excellent job, and he's in the Final Four, and I congratulate you, Bob.
Thank you, Hillier. We're very glad to be here.
You have beaten some very good teams to get here, certainly Warren Central.
Yes, Warren Central and Ben Davis and a Howe team that had only lost five games and a good Cascade team. We've beaten some good teams.
Well, all during the season, your four losses have been to strong teams.
Brebeuf, Franklin Central, North Central, and Mooresville, all good teams in our area.
How do you characterize your team? I know I've seen you practice, and you have a height and you have strength inside.
Well, we think we play very good defense, and we try to press, and then we mix it up at the other end. But Diane Harreth and Colleen Jordan, there are two mainstays inside.
Well, I watched Harreth practice yesterday. I was tremendously impressed with her, as I was with Colleen Jordan.
Yeah, they have a lot of intensity, both of them. And
what is your strategy now? You've, I'm sure, scouted Northup. You've got some tapes and talked to some friends. What is it going to take to beat Northup here this afternoon?
I think rebounding is the key. They're a very fine rebounding team, maybe the best rebounding team we've played all year.
Northup has pretty good scoring balance.
Yes, they do. The one forward, Minerdine, is an excellent player. And then Ramsey and Bull are very good inside. And Williams is a very fine ball handler, so they're two or three dimensional.
What about the press? Do you put a press on?
Yeah, we'll start out in the press. And last couple games, we pressed at the start and didn't really know if it would work. And it did work for a while. And then when it went sour, we took it off. But it's helped us a little bit all year.
Bob, congratulations. Thanks for working with us yesterday. I enjoyed meeting you and your team, and best wishes here today.
Thank you very much, Hillier.
Bob Kirchhoff, the fine coach of Indianapolis, Ron Colley. Here's Dave Riley, who has coached Fort Wayne Northrop to an undefeated season, 27 in a row, rated number 3 in the state of Indiana. And here he is, and I congratulate you, Dave. You've had some good teams at Northrop, and you haven't been able to get to the Final Four, and I know that's a coveted ambition realized here today.
Well, thank you, Hillard. Yes, we've had some good squads there the last 4 years, and we just play such a tough schedule up there in the sectional with the Dwingers and the Snyders and the Southsides, and we've just never been able to get out.
Tell me about the balance of the Fort Wayne Northrop team. Do you rely on that?
Yeah, we hope that if somebody has a bad day, that somebody else can pick it up. And so far, that's happened for us many times this year.
What will it take for you to beat Indianapolis Ron Colley?
We're going to have to shut those two big kids off down there and do a real good job rebounding, it looks like.
You have a great junior, Lori Minerdine.
Yeah, she's a good ball player. She does a lot of things for us besides score that people don't really realize. But she's averaging about 12 rebounds a game and 4 or 5 assists and 4 or 5 steals, so she does quite a bit for us.
I know this is a great thrill for you, and I congratulate you on the season and wish you well here this afternoon.
Well, thank you very much, Hillier.
Dave Riley, the coach of Fort Wayne Northrop. Here is Ron Vermillion, the coach of the Marion Giants, a team defeated by Fort Wayne Northrop last Saturday night in the semi-state in Fort Wayne. Ron, welcome to our telecast, and thank you for joining us. And you've had a good season, and you have an underclass team. You've got a lot to look forward to.
Thanks a lot, Hillier. You're exactly right. We only lose one senior this year from a team that won 12 out of the last 14. We've got a young lady named Gina Johnson coming back who scored 524 points this year. We've got another young lady that's 6 foot to block 140 shots this year. So we really feel good about what's coming up.
Just swung by Scottsburg's Warriorettes, now 24-2 after they defeated Gary Wallace, 62-59. Wallace finishes up the season 23-2, and they are now aside as Scottsburg goes to the championship game. You're looking at the Ron Colley Rebels, Indianapolis Ron Colley High School. This is a ball club a lot of folks respected because they won the city championship, but maybe did not expect to be in this championship Final Four. One of the reasons they are here is number 30. Well, this Ron Colley ball club, there she is, Diane Harreth. She is a 6'2 senior. She leads the ball club in points, 16-7. She's the top field goal shooter, the leading rebounder. She is tied for the top spot in steals. She is also one of the most unselfish players you're going to see. Witness last Saturday against Warren Central when the points were not there for her. She found a cohort to get the ball to. and ended up winning that ball game in what was a mild surprise, perhaps even would classify as an upset, Diane Harrop of the Roncalli Rebels. Now we'll check out the only undefeated team in the Final Four. That, of course, is Fort Wayne Northrop. The Bruins having an outstanding year. One of the reasons is number 45, a 5'11 junior, Lori Meinerding. She is the leading scorer in the ball club, 17-2, and down at the bottom in steals, she's the leader there. But she's number two in field goals, number two in free throw percentage, number two in rebounds, and number two in assists. 5'11 junior Lori Meinerding is the key to the success that Fort Wayne Northrop's had so far this year. And we'll keep an eye on both Diane Harrop and Lori Meinerding in the second ball game of the afternoon. Speaking of that game, it's about set to start. Let's go back across the court again to Scott Gregg.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's time now for our second game featuring the Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins and the Roncalli Rebels. Here are your starting lineups and rosters for the game. First, for the visiting Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins. Number 34, Kristen Deardorff. Number 35, Krista Cook. Number 44, Char Humphrey. Number 50, Wendy Pennington. Number 51, Tracy Lapsley. Number 52, Michelle Starks. Number 53, Regina Johnson. And now your starting lineup for the 27-0 Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins at one guard, a 5'4" sophomore, number 41, Vanessa Williams. At the other guard, a 5'9" senior, number 42, Cindy Westendorf. At one forward, a 5'11" junior, number 43, Jenny Bull. At the other forward, a 5'11" junior, number 45, Lori Meinerding. And the center, a 5'11" senior, number 55, Jill Ramsey. The head coach of the Bruins, Dave Riley. And now your roster and starting lineup for the home team, the Roncalli Rebels. Number 10, Christy Maxwell. Number 11, Lisa Godino. Number 14, Kathleen McCarthy. Number 20, Sherry Carr. Number 21, Jeannie Laurie. Number 25, Karen Elias. Number 31, Gina Carson. And your starting lineup for the 22-4 Roncalli Rebels at one guard, a 5'6" sophomore, number 24, Jenny Sullivan. At the other guard, a 5'6" senior, number 34, Angela Forey. At one forward, a 6-foot sophomore, number 12, Colleen Jordan. At the other forward, a 5'8" junior, number 35, Mary Pendick. And the center for the Rebels, a 6'2" senior, number 30, Diane Harrop. The head coach of Roncalli, Bob Kirkhoff.
So we're ready now. The Bruins of Fort Wayne Northrop, 27-0. The Rebels of Indianapolis, Ron Colley at 22-4. They'll meet Scottsburg for the state title. The winner here will nonetheless. We'll be back with the opening tip-off. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Ladies, this is their first appearance ever. In fact, for all of them here at Market Square Arena as a player, it's a monstrous place. Does that affect the players? We put that question to Colley and Jordan of Ron Colley.
Playing in a new arena doesn't bother me at all. It's not that hard to adjust to or anything. The one thing that helps me the most is having Diane Harris. She's helped me a lot. When I was a freshman, she helped me a lot. And that's one of the main things that helps me.
Having seen Ron Colley play, Tom May, Hilliard Gates, don't be misled. They look like anything but a Final Four basketball team at times. They're very quiet, very simplistic. They just seem to get the job done. Those are the numbers you saw on their screen. And they beat some pretty darn good ball clubs to get here.
Well, you know, just looking at their big girls, I think they should be here. They have some good size.
And they play very, very smart. And Bob Kirkhoff's done a good job in getting them through. They won the Indianapolis City Tournament this year. And then last Saturday night out at Ben Davis High School beat Warren Central. And I noticed that Sue Parrish, the coach at Warren Central, sitting a couple of rows behind us here. So they didn't have any free ride into this thing.
Well, we're going to talk to Sue later.
Rebounded by Diane Harris again, or Colleen Jordan, rather. And now finally Fort Wayne Northrop will get a chance to look at their offense for the first time of this ball game. Scottsburg will play the winner of this one for the state title, and our telecast coverage begins tonight at 7:30 here on the IHSAA television network. Loose ball thrown away.
Jerry, the officials are Jill Wyatt of Fairmont and Jim Cox of Gas City.
Should you point them out on the screen here, Hilliard, or just
let yes, the audience? That's Jill on the right and Jim on the left.
Thank you very much. No score yet. Ball game just getting underway. Northrop trying to get something on the scoreboard. Nothing doing there. The rebound is taken out by Diane Harris. She is a 6'2 senior, averaging 16-7 and almost 12.5 rebounds per ball game. And I made a point earlier to tell you she also plays very intelligently because Warren Central took the offense away from her last Saturday. She just turned around and let Colleen Jordan get 22. There's Harris, first 2 points of the game. She is the leading field goal shooter on the club, hitting 58% of her shots. Tom, we talked about the previous ball game, Scottsburg, Gary Wallace, important not to get in a big hole. I suppose that's probably true in any kind of a basketball game at this level.
Well, first of all, that was a nice shot there before we talked with Cindy Westendorf. Outstanding outside shot. I'm interested. Both teams are half-court offensive teams here. They're totally different from the last two teams we saw with an up-tempo type of game. They both have excellent front lines, although here we have Northrop on the floor with the floor.
That's Vanessa Williams, the quickest member of that team.
Westendorf deflected the pass away. It was picked up by Fort Wayne Northrop, and the foul was being called against Indianapolis Ron Colley. We'll take one more look at it.
Well, you can see her penetrating to the basket, and you just got the little push-off, of course, by 24 Sullivan, trying to prevent the easy basket. Probably a smart foul, but you don't want to get another one like that very soon.
All right, so the inbounds trigger man will be Cindy Westendorf, that 5'9 senior. Gets it in. They take the outside shot, and the rebound is knocked away to the near side and picked up by Cindy Westendorf again. Ron Colley in what, coach, a man-to-man or in the zone here?
Right now, it looks just like a sagging man-to-man because they are going with the cutters.
There was the steal taken out of there by Angela Forey. And stolen back at the other end by Lori Meinerding. Meinerding brings it across the timeline. It's the traffic sort of clear and sets up now. Both ball clubs trying to find their feet. And the rebound on that missed shot by Colleen Jordan, only a sophomore. Jordan just had one of those nights that careers are made of last Saturday night against Warren Central. We'll talk more about that. That's a shot way off the mark. I assume it was a shot taken by Mary Pendick. High ball game at 2, 5.5 minutes to play. And
it's a traveling violation, Jerry. They're trying to get Cindy Westendorf to take more outside shots for Northrop.
Comparing these two ball clubs, Ron Colley would have the advantage defensively, giving up only 36.8 to Northrop's 42. Northrop's a better offensive club, 56-1 to 55-4, so there's really not much to write home about in either of those categories when you put the numbers together and compare them. The rebounds, 35-4 for Northrop, 34-7 for Ron Colley. Here's another turnover. And again, much like the first ball game, both clubs just trying to get settled down. Ron Colley with the basketball, coached by Bob Kirkhoff, a graduate of Indianapolis Cathedral High School and St. Edward's University in Austin, Texas. And a substitution for Ron Colley, 31, Gina Carson. comes into the lineup replacing Jenny Sullivan. Now, Jenny Sullivan has had shin splints. In fact, Bob Kirkhoff says he's amazed at how well and how long she plays with those shin splints.
Well, we had a girl, if you remember, a few years ago, Tammy Hamill, had severe shin splints and developed some stress fractures. And they're very painful. You can play, but it takes a lot of heart by a young lady to go ahead and do so.
Neither ball club showing as much offensively in the first couple of minutes of this ballgame. In fact, first 3 minutes or so with 4:45 to play here in the first period. Here's a foul being called against Ron Colley. It is on Mary Pendick, number one on her.
Well, I think in this particular instance, you know, they're throwing the ball to the big girl underneath the basket. She's trying to take it to the basket. I think in that situation, 34 actually got her, but Jimmy was screened off a little bit. And I think they call the foul on 35 on Ron Colley, of course, Pendick. At this point, Northrop is trying to up-tempo the basketball game, and Ron Colley's trying to go more of a half-court offense, but as of now, it isn't working for either team.
Good rebound by Diana Harith again. Harith is not afraid to take command of a basketball game. She's a good shot size lady at 6'2". And also has an awfully good head on her shoulders. She will think the play all the way through to the finish. 4 minutes, 15 seconds to play. First period, only 4 points scored, two by each ball club in the early going of this contest. Out with the rebound is Jill Ramsey. Jill?
Ramsey has been rebounding very well, and that's going to be a key to Northrop's possible success here. If they beat Indianapolis, Ron Colley, it'll have to be Ramsey rebounding well.
Jenny Bull, yes. Jenny Bull is a 5'11 junior, one of a couple of players averaging in double figures for this ball club with a 12-2 scoring average. Her first couple of points of the game, and Northrop has the lead at 4-2 with 3 minutes and 35 seconds to play.
Williams.
She's got it. Vanessa's first 2 points of the contest. So just like that, it's a 4-point lead. It's 6-2 in favor of Fort Wayne Northrop. And that, of course, obviously this early in the contest is the biggest lead of the ball game.
Williams really has fine speed. She really gets up and down the floor very well.
Double dribble being called against Indianapolis Ron Colley. Substitutions now for Fort Wayne Northrop. 53, Regina Thompson will enter the lineup. And back in, Jenny Sullivan for Indianapolis Ron Colley. Bob Kirkhoff just wanted to talk to Sullivan and get her settled down just a little bit. She will not score a lot of points. Number 24, 5'6 sophomore, 3.2 per game, but she's very, very important getting the ball across the timeline in their half-court offense. Basket's going to count, and the foul is on Jenny Sullivan, number two on her. Good move that time to the hoop by Jenny Ball for her second bucket. We'll take another look at it here.
Well, in this situation, it was just good penetration by Jenny Bull, and she took the ball right to the basket and drew the foul.
Jenny Bull, by the way, was All-Summit Athletic Conference this year, and like a number of these players you've seen on the court today, they are multi-sport stars, if you will. Jenny also plays volleyball and track at Northrop High.
Well, you were commenting a moment ago about the young Jordan girl having such a fine game, but I can see in many cases she's a good athlete, but they've always got two or three girls around Horath. And when you do that, that matches her up with somebody else, and then she's really going to excel. Obviously, the Horath girls are very, very fine basketball player. I can tell that just by watching her.
Leinerding dropping it inside to Jenny Bull, and the foul is called, and Bull started to say we go to the line. I'm not so sure that's true or not. Timeout will be taken, I believe, with 2 minutes and 50 seconds to play here in this first quarter. And it's an 8-2 basketball game. Fort Wayne Northrop is out in front. Yes, timeout is taken, so we'll do the same. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. It's 5'4 sophomore. One of the keys. We'll probably see some pressing defense here today. How will she handle that?
First off, you have to have speed, and you have to be able to keep, well, stay patient. I always have Jill behind me, and there's always Jenny in the middle and Lori down on the side with Cindy.
Northrop Bruins are up by six now with the basketball. Now they missed the shot, and the rebound comes off, and Sullivan's got it now for the Rebels of Ron Colley High School. A very small school to the south of Indianapolis, only 833 students. And Fort Wayne Northrop, a somewhat larger school of 2,284. They've got the basketball. They've got that six-point lead with 2.5 minutes to play here in the first period. Not much of an offensive display by either ball club to this juncture. Rebounded by Northrop, back up, and they've got it good.
Jill Ramsey.
Jill Ramsey's first 2 points of the game.
You know, Jerry, I'm really impressed with Bull, Minor, Ding, and Ramsey, the front line of Northrop. They're very strong, and the thing they do offensively is put the ball on the floor and take it to the basket.
That is Ramsey in there again. Hilliard pointed out that, well, on that baseline, she's been a terror, and she's wearing those braces on both knees. Doesn't seem to slow her down a bit. Substitution, 41 coming in for Fort Wayne Northrop is Vanessa Williams. She was on the bench briefly. She'll come in and replace Kristen Dierdorf, the 5'7 freshman. A couple of substitutions so far in the ball game for the Bruins of Northrop High. Just inside 2 minutes in the first quarter. Rebounded by Sullivan, or up by Sullivan, rather by Jordan. And a missed shot and a foul.
The foul's on Jenny Bull, I think.
And on Jenny Bull, that's personal foul number one.
It was a nice offensive rebound. Of course, it all started with Diane Harreth taking the ball across the lane. She caused the penetration, and then as a result, Jordan was able to come in for the offensive rebound.
Jerry, it's interesting. Northrop has built this 10-2 lead without a point from Lori Meinerding, their outstanding player.
Well, in each instance, I believe, Hilliard, in the four teams we have seen here today, which we've already seen the first game with Scottsburg winning, if you've got a player like a Meinerding, or in the case of Ron Colley, a Diane Harreth, that has led you all year long, and I'm sure Coach Tom May would concur with this, they got to score if you're going to win this kind of a ball game. They can't have much of an off day, can they, Tom?
Well, no, they can't have the off day, but at the same time, many times what happens, the other team becomes so concerned with stopping them that your other players that have been role players up to this point can pick up the slack, and many times they'll give you the game.
Diane Harreth with a sensational defensive play. And the Ron Colley Rebels get it again.
I think she put her volleyball talents into that.
And
she
is an outstanding volleyball player, by the way. You're right. Not a good shot along that baseline. And here comes Northrop trying to run the break. The ball is deflected two or three times and finally picked up by Ron Colley and properly, yes, a walking violation.
It's a nice call. The thing I'm impressed with Northrop is they really don't get the ball to their guards and try to run the break. Meinerding gets the rebound, dribbles it the full length of the floor, so does Bull, and that's unusual. You know, normally you want your guards to do the ball handling and running the break and making the key passes.
Well, I think Ron Colley now is set up in some sort of a zone. Tom May, we'll take a look at it here again. It's difficult from this angle to really pick up on what kind of a defense they're running, but it's got to be some kind of a zone.
It's a 2-3 zone, but they're rotating around,
okay.
And where the wings are constantly rotating down to that low position.
Nice turnaround move by Lori Meinerding. Nothing happening, though, and the rebound coming off to 34, Angela Foy, the 5'6 senior starting guard of the Rebels of Ron Colley. The ball game was tied at 2. It is now 10-2 in the final 45 seconds of the first period. Northrop has had the better of it since it was tied at 2. Lobbing it inside to Harreth. Nice move. Diane has all four of the points now for the Ron Colley Rebels.
That was a nice move, Jerry, and it was even made more important because she made the move to her left, which is not her strong hand.
Here's a turnover, a walking violation on Jenny Bull, the 5'11 junior. Only an announcer would notice something like this, Tom, but I don't think I've ever done a broadcast with a team whose smallest number was 34. I got ready to put down the scoring sheets here and realized that Fort Wayne Northrop's smallest number was 34. There's no 10s or 11s or 20s. Only a guy like us would figure that out, Hilliard.
You might be the only guy that would
probably
notice
would,
that.
Probably would, you know, just one of those things that I thought, well, my, I must have missed something here. I think I had five players wearing numbers with 50 or better.
Well, you know something else? They have a very, very large size lineup. You know, they're very tall, very strong. Maybe they need the bigger numbers.
To support them, I suppose, perhaps. Meinerding moved it up court and knocked it out of bounds, but last touch they say by Sullivan of Indianapolis Ron Colley. Ron Colley Rebel school colors are red, white, and blue. They are seated behind us, and 2 hour and left. Look over into their area with Bob Kirkhoff, who has been around for a long, long time, and one of the genuinely nice people in the coaching ranks also. Nice move to the hoop, nothing happening. Tapped up once, twice, and a foul called. And they're indicating it'll be on 55, Jill Ramsey of Fort Wayne Northrop. If it is, and they say it is, that's number one on her, and Tom May takes a look at it again.
Well, again, you have the penetration by Williams, and she's putting the ball up in the glass. And, you know, the thing they're finding out right away is Diane Harreth is really having a tough time. She's having to take on three girls at the same time that are almost as big as she is. And, of course, Jordan right now is sitting down, and that's a tough job.
That's the end of the first quarter. It has been, for the most part, a Fort Wayne Northrop first quarter of play. After the game was tied at 2, it's now 10-4. Six-point lead for Fort Wayne Northrop over Indianapolis Ron Colley. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. Ron Colley, she has all four of the Rebels' points at this point of the ball game. State finals, of course, for Diane and the rest of the gals. A dream come true. And when did this dream start for Diane Harris?
I think I've had a realistic dream of being in the state championship ever since last year when we started doing so well. And, you know, because that was the first sectional that we had won. And then it was like, you know, we can do it.
You may not have heard of Ron Colley High, but they've got two state championship trophies already in their trophy case. They were the 1981 volleyball champions. And last November, not too far from where we are tonight at the Hoosier Dome, they won the AAA football crown, the Ron Colley Rebels did. So they're looking for that third showcase edition, if you will. Second period just underway. All Fort Wayne Northrop in the first period, leading by a score of 10-4. Rebound loose, picked out of there by Indianapolis Ron Colley's 35, Mary Pendick. Ron Colley, Tom May, needs to get something going here offensively. They moved the ball, I guess, fairly well. They've done some things well, but they don't have much to show for it right now.
I think they're going to call this foul on Tracy Lapsley.
All right, that's number one on here.
Well, I think the important thing, as Hilliard mentioned, is Diane Harith is trying to and having to do it all. She's trying to make something happen, to give it to her credit. The other girl's going to have to pick up the slack. They're going to have to start shooting the basketball because they are really packing in on Diane, and they have the size to really bother, which is evident there.
There it is right there. Diane could not control the inbounds pass. Northrop brings it up. One other point to make, Tom. You talked about the fact that Diane Harith is now trying to hold off a good-sized front line of Northrop with two or three good-sized players during the season, over a long haul of a 20-game season. You're not going to see very many ball clubs that got that kind of size along the front line, are you?
I haven't seen a team with this size in 4 or 5 years since we've been there. This is the biggest team I've seen as far as bulk and size.
Yep.
Very, very strong girls. Not heavy girls, but just big and strong.
Diane Harith with that rebound, and she has the basketball. There's what they got to have. That's Mary Pendick down along that baseline area. Mary getting her first 2 points of the game. In fact, the first 2 points scored by Ron Colley that have not come from Diane Harith.
There's
Minerding at the other end.
Well, you're wondering where she was, and there she is. She finally decided to take it the full length and shoot the basketball.
Got a nice shot. You're speaking of shots. What about the first half stats? Here is a foul being called in front of us on Tracy Lapsley, number two on her. First quarter numbers in.
33% for Fort Wayne Northrop and 13% for Ron Colley. They were 2 out of 15, Northrop 5 out of 15. And there were none in. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
It's all right. We were going to wait.
You told me never to interrupt your play, by the
way. No, I did not. 6 minutes and 41 seconds to play, first half. Ron Colley with a 6-point deficit, but they got the basketball. Here is Harith, missing, and a foul. And it should be on 43, Jenny Bull. Number two on Jenny. And we'll take another look at it here and watch. Jenny doesn't say she committed the foul. We'll see. Here's that little cross-court pass.
A nice forward pivot baseline move, and he says she leaned into her for the foul.
There is Bob Kirkhoff, head coach of this Ron Colley ball club. He has spent 20 years coaching the boys in the CYO ranks in town, won 250 ball games doing that as Harith misses the first one. His fifth year at Ron Colley with a record of 85-20, he's won 81% of his games. He's not a coach. He does not teach at Ron Colley. He is an insurance man and has been for 28 years. And I asked him the other day, I said, you selling any insurance? And he says, well, I've got a few other things on my mind right now, but his clients are all going to be taken care of.
There's the very first free throw made in this game, and I was trying to get to the free throw statistics of that.
Did you get those figured out?
No, not.
Oh, okay, fine. Well, let us know. 6 minutes and 18 seconds to play. First half. Ron Colley and the zone defense trail by 5.
You mean we're going to be on the air tomorrow?
There's. Well, we got another tournament scheduled here tomorrow, the Midwestern Collegiate Conference tournament, so perhaps so. Rebounded by Harith again.
It's very obvious Ron Colley is going to give Northrop the outside shot.
They don't have much faith in them being able to make that, apparently. Got it down to Colleen Jordan, of a young lady who played so very well last Saturday night in the semi-state championship game. Gets her first 2 points. She had one of those second halves. Boy, you want to dream and bronze it. We'll tell you more about what she actually did if we have an opportunity here. Nice outside shot that time from Jenny Bull. Jenny is the top scorer now for Northrop with a half a dozen points. We're talking about Jordan. Last Saturday, she had all six of the team field goals in the second half of play and took all of their attempts, all nine in the second half. She finished up with some 22 points, and the reason she had it was because she was posted low under the hoop to the left side. And Warren Central simply went out and played strong defense on Harrith, like they didn't get done that time. And Harrith got rid of the ball, got some assist, and got the ball down to the open man, and that's how they won that ball game.
Well, that was a nice pass there from Mary Pendick. She really made a nice pass to Harrith, and Harrith knows what to do with it when the ball goes to her. And there you go. You got Meinerding again.
Well, she's got a nice shot.
She's an excellent basketball player, only a junior.
You know, the other thing is, as a coach, I'd give the ball to her more, I think. Let her shoot the basketball a little bit more.
It's deflected and picked off by Northrop again. Vanessa Williams makes it to the right side. Now sets the pattern back out to Meinerding. Meinerding kicks it away, and it is picked up over there by Fort Wayne Northrop. Here is Westendorf off the mark, and the rebound underneath to Diana Harrith again. She has been everywhere. She's doing it at both ends of the court right now. 4:25 to play, first half. Offensively, rebound picked up by, now there's Harrith again. Harrith again, and finally good. Diane with 5 points in the period, 9 in the afternoon, and the lead is chopped to 3. It's been as big as 8.
I think if she keeps this up, I don't know what the rebound record is for the state finals, but she's sure going to be close to it if she can be in here for 2 games today.
Getting a ton of them. Mary Pendick takes one down this time. Pendick, as they fill the lanes and finally let Harrith catch up. Boy, Diane's going to have to be in great shape to go at this speed all afternoon long. Trying to lob it inside to Colleen Jordan, and they couldn't. And at the other end, they've got the 2 points on a good, quick move that time by Vanessa Williams.
Well, she has good speed. And, you know, when she gets that ball to her right hand, she can really accelerate and take the ball to the basket.
She's a volleyball and track star also at Northrop High School. Another rebound, another 2 points, and perhaps a three-point play. Diane Harrith with her third field goal this period. We'll look at it again and watch the good, strong second effort here by Diane.
You also got the outstanding pass from Jenny Sullivan that set that play up. And Diane really stays with the basketball. She has excellent balance.
Meinerding drew the foul.
John Osler is keeping stats for us again this week, and he tells us that is 8 rebounds so far in the ball game for Diane Harrith to go along with 11 points. Three minutes, 24 seconds to play, first half. Harrith cannot convert the three-point play, and the rebound ripped out of there by Jill Ramsey. Northrop leading by 3, 18-15. It rolled and rolled and rolled and finally fell out by Kristen Deerdorf. And a foul being called against Ron Colley.
Well, again, Ron Colley is content to give him that outside shot. And, of course, as soon as they shoot, they immediately go in there, and Northrop really hits the boards. And the thing I've noticed about Northrop, they're also subbing a number of players. They now have 53 in there, as you indicated, Regina Johnson, who's playing very, very well. And they're giving the rest they vitally need. And Diane Harrith is still in there, which is going to really take its toll throughout the game, unless she is a very, very finely conditioned athlete, which I hear she is.
Colleen Jordan's second personal foul sends Lori Meinerding to the free throw line for the first time of this ball game. She's a 68% free throw shooter. 5 points so far in this ball game for Meinerding, averaging 17-2, and leads the ball club in that category. Now it is 20-15, 5-point lead. Northrop, they've been ahead by as many as 8. Ball game was tied way back at 2, and then Northrop just ran away and hit for a few minutes. Christy Maxwell almost let it get away, and finally tried to save it, did throw it away, and here comes Northrop again. Regina Johnson, her first couple of points. 5'9 junior, timeout taken by Bob Kirkhoff and Ron Colley. 2:49 to play, first half, 22-15. Northrop leads the Rebels, one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. Lori Meinerding with a half a dozen points in this ball game for Fort Wayne Northrop. Goals, of course, is something that many of us set. How about the goal of Lori Meinerding?
Winning the championship really means a lot to me because it's a goal that I've been thinking of ever since my freshman year, and we just finally got here.
Very attractive, very talented young lady. 22-15 is the score. 7-point bulge for Fort Wayne Northwest Brooms. Unbeaten in 27 ball games so far this year. And at the beginning of the season, they were rated number 18 in the state, finished up number 3 in the final poll. In fact, the coach of the number 2 team, Noblesville's Lady Millers, Ray Lytle, is sitting right behind us here. Boys, he got a pretty good ball club, and a young lady named Courtney Cox is only a freshman. One of the best players in the state.
That was a fine play by Joe Ramsey. Knock that ball loose to start the break the other way.
And there's a walking violation called against Jenny Bull. Roncalli, even with 2:24 to go on the half, Tom May still doesn't seem to have gotten caught up in the flow of this basketball game.
Well, you know, at this point, you know, he's tried a number of things. He's tried to bring in some girls off the bench to create some things. He's tried to get some girls some rest. And at this point, their game is totally inside. Jordan is out. She must be in foul trouble, the only thing I can understand. I don't know. But she's been sitting down for a long time. She has two.
Yeah. Here's the block shot. Jill Ramsey has it. And a reach-in foul called against 25.
Karen Elias.
Karen Elias. Number 1 on Karen. One of the things you will note about Roncalli is, let's check their shooting percentages. Roncalli from the field hitting 45%. That's not bad, but they don't get that many of those 15-footers from what I have seen of them so far this year, Tom.
Well, you know, it's very obvious that Northam is going to pack it in. They're going to stop Diane Harrith. With Jordan out here, they have an added bonus because now they're going to have to contend with the other side, and they're willing to let the other girls shoot the basketball. And at this point, they're not doing it, and they're starting to lose as far as this game is concerned. I think Bob realizes that. He's now coming back in with Jordan because I've always felt you play with two fouls. Although she's a sophomore, she's young, she may get that third and fourth, obviously.
Jill Ramsey's third point of the ball game, looking for number 4. Ramsey was an All-Summit Athletic Conference player this year. Now she has 4 points. Jill is a 5'11 senior. That's the biggest lead of the ballgame now at 24-19. 9-point differential. They headed to 8 in the first period. 1 minute, 50 seconds to play first half. Much quieter crowd than what we enjoyed in the first half or the first ball game today. Though the Roncalli cheering section behind us and to our left is up and cheering. Northrop section, there's a sea of the burnt orange, brown, and white down to our right, and another foul call.
That's on Jill Ramsey, her second.
Well, in that situation, she tried to do exactly the same thing. She tried to play baseline post defense, and she bodied up a little bit too much of Diane Harrith, and they caught her on the foul.
Speaking of Diane, height, of course, is certainly an advantage in this game of basketball. Diane Harrith stands 6'2".
Well, I understand also she's an excellent athlete.
Missed the shot. Now 24-19.
Diane's only 1 out of 4 at the foul line.
Knocked away. Good hands that time by Colleen Jordan. Here comes Sullivan across the timeline for the Roncalli Rebels as she walked with the basketball. There's been some question about the guards of Roncalli's ability to handle pressure. Now, they did a good job, as I say, in the semi-state. But now they're facing it under conditions that they have never faced before. That is state final basketball. And that's a whole new ball game. Sullivan going out. Gina Carson coming back in. There she is. Gina, 5'6", senior. Diane Harrith has been rather quiet for the last couple of minutes after having a strong surge late in the first quarter, early on to the second period of play. Final minute 5 here in the first half. Meinerding drops it inside, and it's taken away in there by Mary Pendick.
She wanted to throw that ball to Jill Ramsey, but she turned the other way.
Less than a minute to go in the half. 24-15 lead for Fort Wayne Northrop, going for their 28th consecutive win. There is an air ball put up that time by Gina Carson. Meinerding across the timeline, lobbing it down low to the baseline. For the rebound, still won't go. Meinerding has it, and it won't go. And a foul is called on Roncalli. And we'll wait to see as we look at Dave Riley. Watch the frustration set in here on both sides.
That's Jenny Bull again, and she really has an art for getting to the basketball and putting it on the floor and taking it to the basket. And I think, again, that's a third foul on on Jordan, which is a key to this game, at least at this point.
We were talking about the trophy case of Ron Colley. They got a few things going for them at Fort Wayne Northrop also. They were the boys' state basketball champions back in 1974 under a guy named Bob Dilley, who was quite a character. They won the baseball championship 3 years back, Chris Stabretti in 83, and they were the girls' track champions in 81. Sure they'll make room for one more trophy should they win it tonight. Minerding.
I'm not sure. I think when Northrop got to the state final, I think that's when Walter Jordan played.
That's correct. 1974.
And he went on to play at Purdue, I think, with Wayne Walls, and they
that's
had
correct.
A fine, fine group of forwards.
He was an all-conference player there.
I remember Bob Dilley as their coach, so was
correct.
Just a marvelous man. And the kids sure really was. Respected him. He got a lot out of that gang, I'll tell you that for sure. Off the fingertips. Gina Carson, now substitution. Tracy Lapsley, a 5'10 senior, comes into the lineup for Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins. 10-point lead. That's the biggest so far of the ball game.
Jerry, they've taken Laurie Marnering out at this stage.
Well, that's a very, very smart play by Coach David Riley. He's taking the girls out because, you know, he doesn't want them to pick up that last foul with 0.2 seconds to go and also get them an extra rest.
The Northrop Bruins have never trailed in this contest, to the best of my memory. It was very early on in the contest. Were they trailed, John? By a 2-0 score. Then it was tied at 2, and since then it's been all Northrop. So we're halfway through the second game of the afternoon. The winner here gets Scottsburg for the crown tonight. Scottsburg earlier in the day beating Gary Wallace. 10-point lead at halftime, 25-15. Northrop out in front. Maury Minerding, as Hilliard pointed out, playing the final few seconds on the bench across the way. She had 7 points in the first half. She's their leading scorer at 17-2. And all seven of those points came in the second period. She's the top scorer for Northrop. For Ron Colley, Diane Harith with an 11-point first half. She has 11 of the 15 showing on the boards. And again at halftime, 25-15, Northrop leads Ron Colley. We'll take a break, then Hilliard has guests for you. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank.
That inch is yours.
Okay.
The court here. We're halftime of the game between Indianapolis Ron Colley and Fort Wayne Northrop, a team that has won 27 consecutive basketball games. Ron Colley has won 22 out of 26 for the season. The unofficial scoring for Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins, a total of 25 points in a very low-scoring affair so far. There has not been a tremendous amount of momentum at either end of the court. Jenny Bull has 6 for the Bruins. Lori Minerding, the leading scorer, has 7, all in the second quarter. Then Jill Ramsey has a total of 4. Vanessa Williams, 4. Cindy Westendorf, 2. And the other 2 have been scored by Renita Johnson. For Ron Colley, Colleen Jordan has been held at 2 points in this game. She's been averaging just under 12. She also has 3 fouls. Mary Pendick has 2. Diane Horath, a brilliant athlete and a fine basketball player, has scored 7 points in the second period, has 11 for the ball game. And that's all the scoring for Indianapolis Ron Colley in this game this afternoon. 3 players have done all the scoring, and it is 25-15 in favor of Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins. In the opening game here this morning, in an unusual contest, it was won by Scottsburg. The 11th rated team in the state of Indiana defeated Gary Wallace in a seesaw affair. The final score was 62-59. So we'll have either Northrop or Ron Colley in the championship game tonight at 8:05 against Scottsburg. And Scottsburg, a very interesting team that plays in good tempo and has outstanding fundamentals. We'll be back with more halftime activities in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana.
Scottsburg, a winner over Gary Wallace. In case you just dialed our way, we're delighted to have you along here at Market Square Arena today. Scottsburg Warriorettes run their record to 24-2. Gary Wallace closes out the year 23-2. Scottsburg trailed at the end of the first quarter 18-13. Indeed, they were down by 7. And then did a complete flip-flop and led by 7 in the second period to go up 35-28 at the midway point. After 3, though, Gary Wallace had retaken the lead, 52-48, but the final score was Scottsburg 62 and Gary Wallace 59. As far as the first half of this ball game today is concerned, some of the highlights would include Diane Harris. She wears number 30 for this Ron Colley Rebel Ball Club. If they're going to win and play well, she has to have a great ball game. Here she is, number 30 in white. Keep an eye on her as she will pick up a couple of points here early on in this contest for the Roncalli Rebels. There is Sullivan down in the corner. They're trying their best to get the ball into Harith. Now they do, and there's that nice little turnaround five-footer. Very, very effective in that area. Now we'll go the other way and check Fort Wayne Northrop, number 42. Cindy Westendorf, very active in the early goings of this afternoon's ball game. There's one from the baseline left side. Now we'll take a look at Diane Harith defensively. Watch what she does here. She comes out, steps up, and blocks the shot away. And the Roncalli Rebels chase it down. Then Harith again. This looks like the Diane Harith highlight film, but she's been the key in the first half. They get it inside, posted low. Three orange shirts around her, turns around for the spin shot and makes it anyway. And then for the Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins, Regina Johnson, who would come off the bench, picks up the loose ball. Here she is now, 53, Regina Johnson, a 5'9 junior, brings it in, stops and pops, and gets the little 10-footer to the right side. And at halftime, as both ball clubs come back onto the court here at Market Square Arena, it is 25-15, Northrop leading the Rebels of Roncalli High School. We'll take a break, then be back with the second half tip-off. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Arena, Hilliard Gates, Tom May, the coach at Crown Point, and this is Jerry Baker. Here are some first half stats for you, Tom. Take a look at them. We just got a chance to see them ourselves. Obviously, the field goal percentage is pretty bad for both ball clubs.
Well, you know, it's obvious at this point that the only thing Roncalli is getting inside is by Diane Harith, where Northrop has three or four girls and go to the basket, and that's what's creating the free throw difference there. And I think the rebound total is a little bit misleading. I think Northrop seems to be getting many more shots around the basket at this point. Right now, it's Diane Harith against the three girls from Fort Wayne Northrop.
Jenny Bull, by the way, has a half a dozen points for the Bruins of Northrop. And we asked her, what's the week been like leading up to the state finals?
Well, this week has been really exciting. I mean, the school, our school is really going spaz and everything, but it just seemed like it took forever finally to get here.
Spaz, that's a phrase that you use a lot when we're hanging out together. While I'm thinking of it, I've not been feeling tip-top this week. So if it doesn't sound like the guy you're used to, well, maybe that's for the better, I don't know. I got a card. A get well card from the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Could you check and see if they all signed it?
Every one of them.
Did they?
Every one.
Well, I feel better.
In fact, two of them signed it twice.
So I appreciate this from Gene Cato and his fine staff at the Indiana High School Athletic Association. I just want to make sure they all wish me well. There was some doubt, I think, in some cases. So.
Jerry, I congratulate you. This has been a courageous performance, and you're doing beautifully, considering you've had such a tough week.
Well, thank you. It has not been one of my favorites, that's for sure. 25-15 is the score. 10-point. Now, Joe Pate is going to take that card and sign it because he didn't bother to send me one. He was hoping he'd have a chance to jump in today and do this, but you know how those Purdue people are. Don't write. I'm just being funny here. Northrop gets two to start things off of the second half.
Has a bad sign early. Mary Pendick took the shot from Roncalli, missed, and they had an easy bucket at the other end, I think, by Vanessa Williams, number 41.
It was.
She has a half a dozen points now, Tom. I got to believe that Roncalli, with no more luck than they had in the first half of play, is going to have to do something just like that. I think the first 3 or 4 minutes here in the second half, Tom May, are just extremely important for Roncalli. Mary Pendick with her fourth point of the ball game.
Well, I think what Bob's trying to do, he's trying to get some other girls in the offense. He's making the one pass, attacking the defense from the weak side, getting it to Mary, and if she starts hitting, they got to come out and her. And if you notice, then Diane's underneath the basket, and there she is right now.
We're a minute into the second half, and Harith, well, when she gets posted down low like that, I don't think there's anybody I've seen in the state this year that can stop her. What they just have to do is, when she gets posted, to get the ball to her.
Well, what they got to do is either front her, deny the ball in, or else put pressure on the girl making the pass so that she cannot make that crisp pass.
All right, Roncalli is set up in a zone defense, and they're wanting Northrop to shoot outside. Indeed, they do. The rebound by Ramsey puts it back up again and scores. I'll tell you what, Jill Ramsey, who stands 5'11", is a solid-built young lady who still has good speed and quickness. Here is a foul call right at the timeline, right in front of the stat crew across the way. It'll be on 42, Cindy Westendorf. That stat crew over there, by the way, is loaned to or assigned to the Indiana High School Athletic Association by the Indiana Pacers. And I've known those guys for a century and a half, it seems like, and gals for that matter. And boy, they do a great job. Yeah, they got a long year with the college tournaments and the pro ranks. Because we got our own little stat guy over here, John Osler, who pretty much on top of things. Diane Harith with 15.
That was really a nice rebound. She came across the top of the lane, went to the ball, got the rebound, kept it high, and put it right back in.
2 minutes gone, third period. Williams missing. Rebound out of there by Colleen Jordan.
A little momentum switch here now.
Couple of quick trips up floor for Roncalli, and they can put themselves back in this ball game. Here is Pendick inside. Harrit, yes. Diane has 6 of the 8 points for the Rebels here in the third period. We're only 2 minutes and 16 seconds into the third period. Now there's renewed enthusiasm in the Roncalli camp. 5:42 to play, period three. They've cut the lead down to a half a dozen. We'll take a break as they do. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. With 6 of the 8 points scored by the Roncalli Rebels. She is 6'2". Size is extremely important to her.
Being tall has worked to my advantage. You know, they've gotten the ball inside to me a lot, and I think it's helped us. My best shot or area of shooting is around the basket, and that's probably my strongest.
That pretty well says it all. Tom May, they post her down inside low. Then if they get the ball to her, it's really a one on whomever, and she's been the winner so far in most of those square offs.
Well, it's very obvious. If they get the ball at the box where they want her to get the basketball, she's not going to be stopped by anybody. Northrop has. It's unusual. You know, Bob's made some adjustments. Northrop's playing a 2-3 zone, and what Bob has done is dropped all four of his girls low in the baseline, making the long pass over, and with one quick pass, they're able to get the ball in with no help on Diane.
Good outside jump shot about 10 feet in front of the hoop by Jenny Bull. Bull now with 8 points. And the Northrop Bruins continue to lead 31-23. They've been down, or not they, Roncalli's been down by as many as 10. Good defensive play. Then the loose ball picked up. Harrit couldn't get it. Tips it in the air once. Sullivan has got it and brings it out of there. That is Angela Forey. Forey drops it back inside again. And they got the hoop. Great shot by Colleen Jordan. Jordan with 4. Her average is 11-3, but she's been playing with 3 personal fouls. 5 minutes to play, third period. The winner here has Scottsburg all lined up tonight at 8:05 for the championship game. Our telecast coverage on the IHSAA network begins at 7:30. Hilliard Gates will talk with the coaches involved and those who are here this afternoon, get their thoughts on tonight's confrontation. We got it all for you live at 7:30 tonight. Rebound. You know who? Diane Harrit. We'll check with John here in a couple minutes, see how many that might be for her. That's 11 rebounds for Diane Harrit to go along with the 17 points. And Diane Harrit had one more to her total. Nice cross-court pass, and the shot is missed that time by Colleen Jordan. What a super pass that was by Harrit.
In that situation, Colleen just did not square up and get her body where she wanted, rushed it a little bit, and missed a shot.
Now there's an obvious 3-2 zone defense used by Roncalli now. It's a rather passive zone defense, and Minerding shoots over it.
You know, the unusual thing about the zone is they are giving up the jump shot, the free throw line. The girl can shoot the 15-foot shot.
Right, but they're not getting inside at all, Northrop isn't.
No. Halfway through the third period. 33-25. Taken away, and Jill Ramsey comes out with it.
She's one of the best ball handlers on the team and takes the ball out of bounds at the defensive end of the court.
I noticed a while ago, Hillier, they were lined up on the defensive end, and she was the one who tossed the ball in bounds.
She does every time from the defensive end.
They try to get it into her, and Harrit may have picked up. Indeed, she did. Personal foul number one. And a substitution now for Fort Wayne Northrop. Coming into the lineup is 53 Regina Johnson, and also coming in for Roncalli is 25 Karen Elias. Here's a replay of that previous foul. Dave Riley is a coach at Northrop, graduate of Fort Wayne North High School, Ball State University, has his bachelor's and master's degree from there. He's married. He and his wife Sharon have 4 youngsters, Terry, Steve, Scott, and Julie. And I gotta tell you something, he must have a pretty good life going for him, coach, because at 51, he's about, it's like about 35 years of age over there. He may feel on older end of that exterior, I don't know, especially after this kind of a year. And a jump ball, and the arrow is pointing in the direction of Fort Wayne Northrop.
I noticed when you were reading the names of the children that I think there were 3 sons and a girl last.
Yeah.
I think he decided to keep going until he got the girl, am I right?
In fact, Terry, his oldest, is 30 years of age. Oh, probably shouldn't have said that, should I? But anyway, nice family, nice man.
Played ball at Fort Wayne Northside High School.
And a jump ball, and now we'll go back the other way. Dave is also the girls' varsity golf coach, and he's won a couple of sectionals as the coach at Fort Wayne Northrop High School. 22 years of coaching prior to taking over the girls' program at Northrop, including 17 years at Franklin Junior High. So he's not a newcomer to this sport by any stretch of the imagination, Hilliard.
He comes from a golfing family. His brother, Pat Riley, is a professional.
Tapped out of bounds, belongs to Fort Wayne Northrop. Yeah, I could talk him into a couple of free lessons. Yeah. A couple of parts of my game are sick.
No, I've seen your game. I don't think you need any lessons at all.
Well, at least I can get down the steps.
You might need some penicillin, but not any golf lessons.
33-25 is the score. It is Northrop out in front, as they have been, with the exception of a 2-0 deficit they faced at the outset of the ball game. Then they tied it at 2, and since then it's been all a lead for the Bruins. Second effort, no good, and a foul. And according to Lori Minerdy. And if that's her, it's number 2. We'll see it again and see where the foul comes into play.
Well, you can see Jenny Bull again. She likes to put that ball on the floor and go to the right and shoot it. And in that situation, Jordan was sandwiched in between Minor Ding and also, I think, at 53, Regina Johnson.
So here comes Ron Colley walking it across the timeline, trying to set up that half-court offense that has not done much for them to this point of the ball game. Here is the steal by Jenny Bull. Lob pass up court, Vanessa Williams. She'll score. Boy, that's a great effort by Vanessa.
Showed her speed. She really is quick.
5'4 sophomore with a 7'3 scoring average now has 8 points. 35-25, and that equals the biggest lead of the ball game for the Bruins of Northrop High School. After they've been chopped down to what did it get down to? Hilliard, 3 or 4, I believe. Let's check with John over here.
The closest I have is 29-23.
All right, so they got it at least down inside the 6 points or so. Here are the turnovers in the ball game, and on each one of those turnovers, it seems like Ron Colley's been able to do something with it. 1:40 to play in this third period, and the rebound taken down by Colleen Jordan. It was 31-25, so they got it down to a half a dozen at one point of the game. Split the defense and then lost the basketball to Angela Ford. And it's out of bounds to Fort Wayne Northrop. There's Dave Riley. His assistant coaches are Phil Ginder of Ball State Reserves and Sherry Dunn out of IU, the freshman coach. Deanne Ramey of Marion College of Indianapolis helping Bob Kirkhoff, along with Nick Whalage of IU and Vic Somm of Bellarmine College. 1:10 to play in this third period. Rebound comes off long into the hands of Jenny Bull. She's tied up, and the ball will stay in the hands of Fort Wayne Northrop. First ball game, Scottsburg, a 62-59 victory over Gary Wallace. Warriorettes are 24-2. I would assume they are out of here by now and perhaps at their hotel, motel, getting some rest, ready for a pregame meal and to take on the winner of this basketball game tonight. Donna Cheatham's club just did a sensational job today. Here is a blocking foul right in front of the scorer's bench across the way on Regina Thompson.
You know, that was a nice play at the other end by Jenny Sullivan. You know, she reached there and knocked the ball loose. Pendick picked it up and then gave it back to Sullivan. Sullivan drew the foul driving down the sideline. You know, it's a matter, it's going to come right down to that Ron Colley's going to have to shoot the 15-foot shot if they want to or not. And up to this point, they have not elected to do so. And there's one finally. And there we go.
Good call, Coach. Excellent call. And in fact, the first outside shot we've seen in a while. And that is Jenny Sullivan.
I think Mary Pendick hit the second shot of the half, and other than that, they have not shot the ball from outside 10 feet.
Sullivan's first 2 points of the ball game. She's not much of a scorer, 3-2 per ball game. Mainly a ball-handling guard. 29 seconds to play a third period. Here is the steal taken back by Northrop, though. Saved by Jenny Bull. Maybe it's just because of the pace of the first game was so hectic, but this seems almost like a slow-motion basketball game.
It does.
Down to the final 12 seconds. Of the third period. Here is Ramsey. Ramsey's not shy about moving to the hoop, is she? 5 seconds to play, a third period. They got to hurry. Here's the way outside shot that almost went in. Jenny Sullivan from about 35 feet out. So we've gone through three, and it is still all Fort Wayne Northrop. 35-27, 8 more minutes to go for the right to meet Scottsburg tonight. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. From Cindy Westendorf, a 5'9 senior, has but 2 points. She's a good shooter, but she doesn't shoot all that much.
Well, when I first get the ball, I always look for the pass first, and then once in a while I'll shoot. Sometimes not enough, but I'll shoot when I'm open. But I just look for the pass first.
And over on the other side of the lever, for Ron Colley, it's Angela Forey, who has not scored in this ball game. Success depends upon a number of things. Well, she hit her ball club. Angela was asked to analyze that from a team standpoint.
The thing that'll be successful for us is to get it into the big girls. And then if the guys need to take an outside shot, then they take it and then make it. Biggest improvement for me is to improve my ball handling skills and to be able to learn to get it into Diane Colley.
Well, that's how they got it to Jenny Sullivan, and Sullivan knocked home two from outside. It's 35-29. And despite, I'm sure, what Bob Kirkhoff would agree to is not an inspired ball game by Ron Colley at this point, they are still in this thing. Bull missing. Long rebounded across the way by Ramsey. Puts it up and scores.
That was a nice move. And she did that with Diane Harris right in her face.
I am impressed by Jill Ramsey, Tom May. I think she's done an awfully good job for him this afternoon.
She's done a nice job, and she's also been responsible for trying to contain the big girls from Ron Colley underneath the basket. And unfortunately, she just fouled right there trying to do that.
Diane Harris will go to the free throw line. And there is the foul on Jill. That'll be number three. While the starting center, 5'11 senior. We will take a look at it again. And as we do, Hilliard, what kind of numbers we got here on the third period?
In the three quarters, Ron Colley is 33%, 13 to 39. And Northrop is 32%, 15 to 47. 5-7 at the foul line. 1-6 for Ron Colley.
Diane Harris is a co-captain of the Ron Colley Rebels with Gina Carson, first-team All-State preseason. She was the school's Mental Attitude Award winner this year in volleyball, first-team All-State 2 years, as a matter of fact. Likewise, plays softball. And as so often happens with the outstanding athletes on these teams, she is also quite a student. She's a member of the National Honor Society. 17 points to her credit so far this day. She's not had much success at the free throw line. I've got her one out of five.
She heard us.
Now 18 points. 55 seconds gone here in this final period in what has become a quieter Market Square Arena after the wild first game that we had with Scottsburg and Gary Lou Wallace High Schools.
You know, I'm really anxious to see what Northrop does. You know, Northrop has the 7-point lead. All they have to do is really say, come out and get us, and really isolate some people, or they can try to force the ball or shoot the non-percentage shots. And looks like they're electing to shoot the basketball at this point.
They're not rebounding off the offensive board at all, either.
What is the thinking, Tom? Is it too early to start spreading out the floor and killing time right now? Would you do that if you were coaching?
Well, I don't think I'd necessarily try to spread the floor out. That was Harris again. Excellent offensive rebound. I don't think I'd like to spread out the floor, but I do think I'd like to get them out of that paint a little bit so it open up your board strength and your individual moves.
Because you can, with the lead at 7 points, which is now down to five, you can dictate the kind of game that's going to be played out there right now. And I think what you're saying is, don't spread it and kill time, but make them do what you want them to do. They got inside and Bull missing, and there comes Ron Colley again with the rebound. It is taken down in there by Jenny Sullivan. Now, here is a walking violation. And that's the last thing I know that Bob Kirkhoff wants right now as he looks on from across the way. The way the seating is set up here, both schools have their seats on the same side, so all of the cheering is behind us. And when the cameras pan the stands, and you see some empty seats over there, understand, as Jill Ramsey scores her 10th point, that those are fans from either Gary Wallace or Scottsburg who have left the arena, and they'll be back in full force tonight. And there are still tickets available for tonight's game, $5 to get in. That's a heck of a deal. And if not, you can't make it in person. We'll have the telecast for you starting at 7:30. Here is Sullivan missing long, and the rebound knocked free, picked off by Northrop. With 5.5 minutes to go, they lead by 7. 39-32. Meinerding at the free throw line changes her mind. Vanessa Williams off to Westendorf. Now back to Vanessa again. They do a good job, Tom, looking for the open man.
Yes, they do. And they see the open man and they pass the ball there.
And there is the ever-present Diane Heron. Leading scorer, leading rebounder, tied for the top spot in steals. 6'2 senior has 16 rebounds so far to go along with 20 points. That is an all-star performance.
Again, we're sitting there giving them the 12-foot shot.
And they're going to take it apparently, but miss it. And the loose ball on the floor picked up by Fort Wayne Northrop, and a foul is called. And the indications are it'll be on Mary Pendick, who climbs off the deck at MSA.
Well, in that particular situation, Forey had to shoot the outside shot, would not fall for our minor ding, went up and got the rebound and drew the foul.
A poor showing, 4:44 to play in the fourth period. 39-32, Northrop leads Roncalli. Timeout is taken. We'll do the same. One of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. Mary Pendick, there she is on your screen, number 38, a 5'8 junior, has 4 points so far today. Mary explained that each player has a specific thing that she would like to do, and Mary described her role this way.
My role in this game will be to help bring the ball up the court and get the ball inside to Diane and Colleen and to hit the outside shot.
Mary Pendick, 5.7 per game scoring average, almost three rebounds, not with a 4 point total so far today. 7 point lead again. It seems like it's been on that number for an eternity. Here is the 5 second call against Fort Wayne Northrop. They did not get the ball in the air. Now, it doesn't have just to be in the air. It's got to be touched by an inbounds man. Within 5 seconds, they didn't get it done. So good defense that time by Roncalli. And the Rebels will inbounds down in front of their own bench. And let's see if they try to just force it inside to Harris. They do. She's got it now. And the rebound is coming out to Meinerding. Almost taken away. Now Laurie has it and brings it across the timeline. 4.5 minutes to play in this basketball game. Folks down in Scottsburg are getting already tuned up and fired up for the championship game tonight. They'd love to have that first trophy sitting in their showcase. Here is Jenny Ball. Jenny hits double figures. She has 10.
You know, that was created totally by Meinerding. She made the penetration, saw her all the way, made the nice pass, and they converted on the easy basket.
Shot deflected away from Jenny Sullivan. Picked up inside, though, by Harris. And the rebound to Northrop again. They've got a lead man, Vanessa Williams. Here is Vanessa stopping. Good move.
Another good play by Lori Meinerding.
So Williams has 10. Jenny Bull has 10. And Ramsey has 10. And now it is an 11-point lead. And that is the biggest so far in this ballgame for the Bruins of Fort Wayne Northrop High School. Trying to add to it. Meinerding will have the foul. Is on Angela Forey. Lori Meinerding now becomes the fourth Northrop Bruin to hit double digits. She has 11 with a chance to go to 12.
That was an excellent move. They advanced that ball up the floor, created the fast break opportunity, and they converted.
Roncalli Rebels will take timeout to gather around Bob Kirkhoff with 3:36 to play in this fourth and final session. It's a 13-point lead for Fort Wayne Northrop. We'll take a break. One of your network sponsors, American Fletcher National Bank. 55, Jill Ramsey of the Fort Wayne Northrop Bruins has 10 points. When Hilliard and I talked earlier, she takes the ball out of bounds a lot of times in backcourt. There's good reason.
It is unusual for a center to take the ball out and handle the ball a lot, but Coach Riley relies on me a lot for my ball handling and my leadership and my ability to stay calm in tight situations.
Much like what you have done today, Hilliard, nonetheless. Lori Meinerding-Da with 12 points, and the lead stretches to 14. That's the biggest of the game. Roncalli just simply not, as Tom May has pointed out, hitting that outside 15-footer that would allow the pressure to be taken off of Diane Harris, who's had a great game nonetheless. Colleen Jordan kicks it away, and out comes Fort Wayne Northrop again. Vanessa Williams, only a sophomore, showing some dynamite ability. You'll see across the way one of the assistant coaches holding up a sign, flex. I assume that refers to the kind of offense he wants his club to run right now.
Vanessa Williams injured her knee on February 8th, and for a moment she thought she might have to have a knee operation, but she's okay.
Here's a foul, and they are pointing toward 34 Angela Foy. I don't want to start any kind of an argument here, Tom May, but we've gone through the first year, you're through with it, of that bench decorum rule. How many tech did you get this year?
Not one.
Not one. I didn't see very many this year, as a matter of fact. And, of course, you are an official and have been for a number of years working up to, what, the semi-state level?
Yes.
And did you get to call any this year?
Yes.
Did you?
Yes.
A number, a large number? Or?
No, not a large number. Probably less than five for the entire year.
I think that's generally what I'm hearing from the other officials I'm talking with, that it's there and occasionally it's something you cannot avoid. You got to call it, but it has not been quite the terror that, whether you like it or dislike it, I'm just saying it's not quite the terror that we had all anticipated it might be.
Agreed.
And I really don't know whether it'll be back next year or not. That'll be the decision the associations will have to make.
Nice rebound by Meinerding. Looks like she's going to draw two free throws.
Here, we'll take a look at it again. Lori Meinerding, a 5'11 junior who leads the club in scoring and steals, has had a very quietly effective ball game today, Tom.
Well, you know, she's a very smooth player. She's not a real flashy player. Many times a player like that goes unnoticed, but she's the kind of player you have to have on a team to win, and she's a quiet type that gets the job done and somehow ends up with her 15 or 16 by the time it's over with and 12 or 13 rebounds.
I've seen her be a flashy on occasion.
I think she probably has that ability to do it, Hilliard, if the opportunity presented itself, but she's got Ivor down for 12 points now 13. And it's one of those situations where you look down and say, oh, yeah, so she's got 13 points. She's done it very, very effectively.
And she's not forcing any shots here today.
Oh, no, and as you indicated before, she's made some very nice passes. She sees her teammates and gives the ball off. You know, the thing I'm impressed about Northrop, they have a nice team. You know, I mean, they're playing eight or nine girls, and nobody off the bench has hurt them. Where at the same time, Bob over there has really only been confident to be able to use one girl, I think maybe two, for only 10 or 12 seconds, and he gets his team right back in. Yeah. And what's happened? Northrop has just worn them down.
So we talked to Dave Riley. He's had a good team for the last several years, but couldn't get to this level of the competition. There were a lot of good teams in the area.
Again, she'll get the hoop and go to the line.
Well, you know, that situation shows the heart that she has. Her team is 15 or 16 points behind. It could be at this point you think the game's over with, and yet she's still going back for that second and third try on the boards. That shows you just how much intensity and competitiveness she has in her.
Speaking of confidence, well, that's one of the things you've got to have to play this basketball game, and Mary Pendick, number 35, of Ron Colley, talked about that.
With the way we've been playing, we can beat anybody, because just as long as our guards do good and D hits all our inside shots and Colley plays well, then we'll just keep winning.
Diana Harris missing the three-point play conversion. And Fort Wayne Northrop comes back with the basketball. They are unbeaten, 27-0 coming into this afternoon's game. Ranked number 3 in the state. And right now, very much in command. Meinerding gets smacked across the bridge of the nose and will go to the free throw line. Inside 2 minutes now. And again, our coverage tonight begins at 7:30. They'll tip off the game at 8:05. Hilliard Gates, before tonight's telecast at 7:30, you'll be talking with the coaches involved with the title game, and I believe also the losing coaches this afternoon to get their thoughts on tonight's game.
That's correct.
So you got a busy night coming. Now more substitutions for Ron Colley, 21. Jeannie Laurie, 5'7" junior, comes into the lineup. And at least at this point, to this point, it has been Northrop really on a roll today. Tom, I don't know whether they have played that well or if Ron Colley has not had a good day. And sometimes you can't tell what's cause and what's effect, whether a team has not played well, whether the other team just played so well they didn't let them get in their flow of the game.
Well, you know, in the situation today, Northrop has done what they've had to do, and that is win this game. Ron Colley's the type of team that is not a real, real smooth type of team. It's not the team that pushes the ball up the floor. They were trying to force the ball inside, and Northrop has played the game. They've stopped Ron Colley's total inside game second half, and they have got the ball down the floor and converted for some easy baskets. It's going to be an interesting game tonight if Northrop goes on to win, because they're two very well-balanced teams.
In fact, when we finally do confirm who will be in that championship game, that's one of the questions I want to ask you, what you might project for tonight's championship game. And if there is a plus for winning, assuming that Northrop does, and they're up now by 15 points with a minute 45 to go, by winning with this kind of a margin, it will give you, as a coach, I assume you think about this, don't you, Tom, a chance to rest some of your players, spread them out a little bit, give them an extra half hour or so rest, or maybe not a half hour, but 15 minutes, because you're going to come back with less rest than the first games, first teams did today.
Well, you know, normally you would think that. However, you only got a minute 44, and if it comes down to 2 minutes rest one way or the other,
so
it's,
what,
it's really not going to help you. The important thing is now, you know, obviously you don't want to go have a girl go down with an ankle sprain or something of that sort that would really cost you. But at the same time, if you've never been here before, you still think the other team's going to score 16 points in about 12 seconds on you.
When would you feel really secure, Tom, with this, let's say, a 10-point lead? Maybe with 1 second to go in your case?
This year with a 10-point lead, maybe with about 30 seconds, we might have got everybody in.
You coaches are all alike. You just know the roof is going to cave in at any moment on you.
Nice block by Joe Ramsey. Fine block.
She had 15 points in the victory over Marion's Giants on Saturday night in Fort Wayne, which was one of her better performances in recent weeks.
She has played very, very hard today, and she's played at both ends of the floor, and that's a credit to her being an all-around basketball player, not just a scorer.
No question, she was a key here today.
And a steal on the inbounds pass by Meinerding. Ron Colley had a 22-2 year last year, so this is not a fluke that they are here, at least from a one-loss standpoint. Last year, Fort Wayne Northrop, 19-2, but they had a 16-2 JV squad, so that also fed up the ladder.
Well, Hillier, I think that was an example. Joe Ramsey just took it the full length of the floor, made the penetration to the free throw lane, dished the pass off, and should have been an easy bucket that just did not fall for him.
It looks like Bob Kirkhoff is going to allow some girls to see some playing time. Lisa Godino, number 11, coming in. Kathleen McCarthy, a 5'10 sophomore, likewise entering the lineup. Now, number 35, Krista Cook for Fort Wayne Northrop will make her first appearance in the ball game today. And with a minute 7 to go, it's 49-34, a 15-point lead for the Bruins of Fort Wayne Northrop High School. They've got a sea of the burnt orange, brown and white behind us, and they'll be out in full force for the championship game tonight against Scottsburg. We know what kind of a noisy crowd they brought with them. Out of bounds to Fort Wayne Northrop. The pace for this game, Hilliard, was set very early. I think you both agree. It was set with, what, first 5 minutes of the ball game,
right?
Uh-huh. And not much has changed since that point in time.
Well, it was just a matter, you know, we keep alluding to the fact that Ron Colley had elected they were going to get that ball inside at any cost. And I think all the turnovers have been made with two and three girls around Diane Harris. And I don't even think they shot the 15-foot shot till they had to.
And a reach-in foul on Diane. I don't think Diane's had a minute of rest in this ball game. I think she's been out there the entire, almost 32 minutes now. Final 42 seconds, Hilliard.
Tracy Lapsley and Michelle Starks have gone in for Wayne Northrop. Michelle making her first appearance in the game.
And the Bruins will continue to insert players. On your screen is Char Humphrey, a 5'10 sophomore, and following right behind, number 50, Wendy Pennington, also a sophomore at 5'6". And the players for Fort Wayne Northrop going out of the lineup, getting a good round of applause, and timeout has been taken. With 42 seconds to play in the game, 49-34, Northrop leads Ron Colley. One of your network sponsors is Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. This is with us, Hilliard Gates from Fort Wayne. Here's truly Jerry Baker, courtside, Market Square Arena. Final 42 seconds of this ball game. It looks for all the world time as though Northrop's got themselves a ticket to tonight's championship game.
Well, I don't think there's a doubt about it. I think they've got this game already in the bag, and now it's important to get these girls rested and ready for tonight. You got a young lady at the line, Krista Cook. She's going to remember these free throws for the rest of her life because she's getting a chance to shoot two, and she made the first.
So the clock will continue to wind down. Ron Colley still trying to pick up some points. Here's a save and a double dribble. But Tom, let's assume it. Well, it is. It's going to be Northrop and Scottsburg tonight. What kind of a game does that give us?
Well, you know, Hillier and I were just talking about that. It's going to be a very unusual game. I think it's going to come down to really who can control the boards. And in my estimation, I think Northrop's going to control the boards. The other thing, you know, Farrell is an exceptional player, but Northrop has four or five girls, can just absolutely put the hurt on you the entire day. At this point, I'd have to give the edge to Northrop if they can contain the forwards, you know, the Gullins and the Westmoreland. If they can control those type of players, I think they have an honest chance to win their state championship. But they also play the second game, which is going to take its toll.
Well, let's thank the folks who made our telecast possible here today. Our executive producer is Michael Davis. Our senior producer, Bob Caldwell. Today's game directed by Dean McDowell. The network director is Peggy McClelland.
Christine Maxwell made that shot.
Unit manager, Bob DeLong. Technical director, Fred Lawrence. Ken Houtson and Jim Miller handled the video. Videotaped by Mike Mettert. They're counting it down, and that's going to be it. It is all over, and the final score is 50-36. Fort Wayne Northrop wins it to run their record now to 28-0. Bob Kirkhoff moving down the line to shake hands with Dave Riley, his counterpart in the other coaching blocks. Hilliard,
just an unusual balance scoring for Northrop in this game. They've passed it around pretty well. Bull had 10, Meinerding 15, Ramsey 10, Vanessa Williams had 10, so there's good balance. Now, Scottsburg had the longest rest, or will have the longest rest, but Northrop had the easier game, Tom.
Well, you know, I really don't think it's going to make a great deal of difference tonight because Northrop, he played a lot of people. A lot of people were able to sit down other than Jill Ramsey. And, I think she paced herself at times and did what she had to do with the game under control. It's going to be a very, very interesting game tonight, and I think from what we've seen, it's going to be a very, very balanced game.
Right, Tom, let's continue. Let's give the folks credit who helped to make the telecast possible. They do a lot of hard work. I've been here for a long time. Bob DeLong on audio, Julie Ward, J.R. Reynolds, Eddie Swanson, Nelson Hastings had the cameras, slow motion replay, Dick Blair, John Osler, stats, electronic graphics, Bud Blaine. Our floor director was Joe Goodrich. Some of the highlights of the game for the Northrop Bruins, keep an eye on number 43, Jenny Ball. Had a very quiet 10 points in this ball game here this afternoon. The 5'11 junior was very effective for Ron Colley. Of course, the key to their success, what they've had all year, was Diane Harith. Here comes 41, Vanessa Williams, a young lady with great speed, 10 points in the ball game, an impressive effort for her. Likewise, Jill Ramsey, number 55. A gal that had 10 points and was very effective handling the basketball. And also, on down the way, Lori Meinerding finishes up with 15 points, a couple of points shy of her scoring average. Nonetheless, a good afternoon for Lori Meinerding, a 5'11 junior. Any reproduction of our telecast strictly forbidden without the express written permission of WTTV, who also has approval of the announcers we use in our telecast, Jerry Baker for Hilliard Gates and Tom May, inviting you to be with us on Saturday morning, March 31st, for our next IHSAA event. That's the Boys Basketball State Championship. But first things first, tonight at 7:30, Tom and Hilliard and I will gather around the monitors here at Market Square Arena again to begin our telecast coverage of the girls' state championship game. First game score, Scottsburg, a winner over the Gary Wallace Hornets by a count of 62-59. Here it was 50-36, Fort Wayne Northrop. Jerry Baker saying so long from Market Square Arena.
Watching another championship event on the Indiana High School Athletic Association Network. Your network sponsors have been American Fletcher National Bank. At American Fletcher, the advantage is yours. The Milk Promotion Services of Indiana. And Farm Bureau Insurance and the nearly 700 Farm Bureau Insurance agents located throughout the state of Indiana.